What is a testamentary trust? Well, folks, in order to understand what a testamentary trust is, we must first review what a trust is. Now, a trust is a fiduciary arrangement whereby the maker, the trustor, the person making the trust, usually it's in writing, right, is going to appoint a trustee, a second party involved, someone of high trust, and that trustee is going to manage assets on behalf of the maker. So the maker is going to place the assets normally into trust. The trustee will handle the trust. And then that is for the benefit of a third party. The third party is called the beneficiary, the individual or individuals that are entitled to the benefits of that trust. Now, as I mentioned, a trust is a fiduciary relationship. And what that means, it's a level of high trust. So there is a high level of responsibility that is placed on the trustee. The trustee must act reasonably. The trustee must act in accordance with the terms of the trust. Now, flashing back to what is a testamentary trust, this is a trust that is created inside your will. If you're writing your will, you would be known as the maker or the trustor. And you would place the terms of the trust inside your will. And inside the terms of your will, you would then appoint the trustee and also designate who the beneficiaries of that trust are. Now, that trust that you're creating inside your will would be, as we qualify, revocable or revocable, meaning that you can change the terms of your trust up until the time you pass away. Once you pass away, that trust that's contained inside your will is then deemed to be irrevocable. That means that you can't change it, or that the actors inside your trust cannot change the terms of the trust. And it's very difficult to change the terms of that trust once you pass away, unless there is a judge's order. Now, why do folks do testamentary trusts? What's the whole purpose behind that? Well, if you have assets that you want to leave to a minor children, this is the most common way that I see. And it could be your children. It could be your grandchildren. And they may not have been of age of majority. In Massachusetts, age of majority is 18. And so when that happens, when you have a child involved in an estate, it's very hard to leave them assets. So the way that we do it is with a testamentary trust. And so that testamentary trust now is going to designate once again who the parties are. And then there's going to be a specific event in which the trust itself will terminate and kick out all of the assets. That's typically when a child reaches age of majority or 21 or 25. You have the flexibility of designating when that event happens. And so the assets will be held in trust up until that point and be managed by the trustee up until the point where the child's able to handle those assets on their own. Now, the trust itself also will be drafted in a way that it can kick out income or some portion of the assets in order to take care of the child while the child's still a minor. It can pay for schooling. It can pay for other types of necessities that the child might need. And so in that way, we can leave assets to minor children. And so that's the most typical way that we see it. There are other uses of a testamentary trust. Sometimes people use them to lessen estate taxes or eliminate estate taxes. But typically what we do is we see that for minor children, when we're handling assets or when the estate is handling assets for minor children. Dave Ceruolo, ceruolo.com.